talks with us.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Mohan Gopal. You know, I would like to speak about just a few cases, you know, where I think the consequence of framing a child for framing the person is really frightening. Justice Patnaik had mentioned about Dr. Kafil Khan. The accusation against him was that he made a speech, right? And he was put in detention, National Security Act. So therefore, a danger to national security. That's why he was preventively detained. When he challenged his preventive detention, the Allahabad High Court set it aside. And I will just read to you one passage from the decision of the Allahabad High Court to show how a person can be framed and what are the consequences. The Allahabad High Court said, a complete reading of the speech prima facie does not disclose any effort to promote hatred or violence. It also nowhere threatens peace and tranquility of the city of Aligarh. The address gives a call for national integrity and unity among citizens. I'll repeat that. The address gives a call for national integrity and unity among the citizens. The speech also deprecates any kind of violence. It appears that the district magistrate had selective reading and selective mention of a few phrases from the speech, ignoring its true intent. So here is a person who talks about national integrity and unity. He says, don't indulge in violence. And he's put under detention for endangering the security of the country. I mean, if you talk about national security, you're endangering the security of the country. It's just amazing, you know, how the whole thing cooked up against him. The second case is from Delhi of, you know, a young student activist. She's supposed to have given a speech. By the way, Dr. Kafil Khan was, you know, in custody for 7 months before he was released. You know, so it's not that, you know, like it happened with Justice Chinnappa Reddy, 10 minutes, it was all over. 7 months he spent in custody. The case from Delhi, a young student activist gave a speech. She was arrested, detained for inciting violence and so on and so forth. She applied for bail. The Delhi High Court said, and I'm quoting now, the prosecution had failed to produce any material that she in her speech instigated women of a particular community or gave a hatred speech due to which the precious life of a young man has been sacrificed and property damaged. Admitted, agitation was going on since long. Print and electronic media was present throughout, in addition to cameras of police department. But there is no such evidence which establishes that the alleged offense has taken place on the act done by the petitioner, except statements under Section 164 CRPC, much belatedly, throughout. Now, this lady got bail after 3 months. She's inside for some other offense, alleged offense under UAPA. But the fact is that, you know, cameras were present, electronic media, police cameras were present.
Where is it? Were present.
And, you know, the whole thing is just cooked up. I said that she gave a speech which incited violence. Now, you know, framing a person is a pretty mild expression, if I may say so, Professor Mohan Gopal. It's just cooking up a case completely, you know, when nothing exists. Put in something and say, ah, this person has said this, or this person did that. Put in a matter of 3 months, matter of 7 months, how does it matter? You know, that is the attitude which I think is very, very frightening. Now, you see, the law of sedition has been set by the Supreme Court way back in 1964, Kedarnath Singh. Subsequently, also, after Mrs. Indira Gandhi's assassination, There again, the Supreme Court reiterated what had been said in 1964. 1964 judgment by Constitution Bench in any case. Now, what has been happening is that the number of cases of sedition have been rising. The National Crime Records Bureau has indicated they started maintaining statistics from 2014 onwards. Every year, there is a rise. Latest figures that are available, official figures are of 2018, 70 cases of sedition. 2019, I will not be surprised if the number has gone up. 2020, I will not be surprised if the number has gone up. Now, the rate of conviction is almost zero. You know, maybe one or two people have been convicted of sedition. And given the judgment of the Supreme Court by the Constitution Bench, I have no doubt that these people will, you know, be acquitted eventually. So, draconian laws, you know, whether it is NSA, whether it is sedition, you know, these, or UAPA, these are being foisted upon people in cooked up cases to keep them in detention for a couple of months, right? Now, it's all right to say that, you know, compensation can be given. Yes, compensation can be given, and compensation, according to me, must be given. But that is not a complete answer. You know, there's a lot of mental trauma. A person who is innocent, who has not done anything wrong, is told that, listen, you spend 3 months in jail, 4 months in jail, right? And after you come out, I'll give you 10,000 rupees or 50,000 rupees or whatever it is. What about the mental trauma of an innocent person, a person who everybody knows is innocent, the police know he's innocent. That's why they cooked up the case. And he's put behind bars, or he or she is put behind bars. What about the mental trauma? How can you compensate that? You know, it's going to be in the mind of that person for the rest of his or her life. And money is not an adequate answer. You know, even if it's a couple of lakhs here or there, which has been given in some cases, that's not an answer. That's a part of an answer. So I think all of us have to be vigilant. Justice Patnaik has emphasized that. All of us have to be vigilant. You know, there's a lot of controversy. I don't want to get into it about, you know, some eminent people. And I find from the participants who are here, some of them are present in this webinar also. You know, they've been named in a charge sheet for doing what? You know, just because somebody's made a statement, all right, so you put their name inside. There are serious consequences of all this. You know, a damage to a person's reputation, trauma, you know. So let's not look at these things, you know, in an isolated manner. These are issues that are confronting us, and confronting us, I'm not talking about, you know, years ago. Kafil Khan was detained in February. This young girl was detained in February. I'm talking about a couple of months ago only, within this year. So these are very serious issues, and I'm glad, Professor Mohan Gopal, that you have taken this initiative. And let's look at it seriously. You know, how many people are being framed? I would go to an extent of saying that cooking up a case is more serious than framing a person. How many cases have cases cooked up? And what is happening about them? We've had instances of children being arrested, right? Say somebody is, you know, 19 years old, 20 years old, and he's found to be 14 years old. And you make some kind of an allegation, put him inside. What happens to that child when he grows up? These are very, very serious questions, and I'm glad you've taken it up. And thank you for this excellent initiative. Thank you.
Thank you so much for those inspiring words, Justice Lokur, sir.